Welcome everyone to the Demystifying Medicine YouTube channel. Today we'll be talking about the allures and dangers behind vaping. But before we start, let's step into Alex's world, a 17-year-old high school student navigating the chaotic world of adolescence and the persistent pressure to fit in. In the hallways at school, Alex noticed a rise in the popularity of vaping amongst his peers. It seemed like everyone was doing it, a trend that was fueled by not only marketing tactics, but also the desire to be relevant amongst his peers. The allure of those sweet-flavored devices was hard to resist. Like many of us, Alex sought quick fixes to escape the stress of exams, social drama, and the overwhelming pace of life. A quick hit of nicotine gave him an instant escape. Nicotine's instant gratification, and with the vast number of flavors, created an escape that seemed harmless, at first. Little did Alex know, each puff was rewiring the brain, creating a dependence on that rush of happiness. It was like a subtle trap, tightening its grip over time. As the days turned into months and the school years passed, the long-term impacts began to reveal themselves. Alex was now experiencing health issues and struggling with addiction. The quick fix had transformed into a long-term problem. Now, as we unfold this story, let's remember that Alex represents countless individuals facing similar struggles. The rise of vaping among young adults and teens is a concerning trend that requires our attention. In the next few minutes, we'll unravel the layers behind why vaping has become a prevalent example of quick fixes, exploring the instant gratification of nicotine and the science that makes it all so addictive. Now let's break it down. What exactly are those quick fixes, and why can they be so alluring? Quick fixes are almost like shortcuts to feeling good, providing a rapid escape from the stressors of our daily life. Whether it's the instant boost we get from a sugary snack, the thrill of a social media notification, or the hit of nicotine from vaping, every human will crave that momentary relief. And speaking of vaping, it has emerged as a prevalent example of these quick fixes. The devices promise a quick escape from life, a momentary pleasure that can seem harmless. But are these shortcuts worth the potential long-term consequences? Think about it. We all have our go-to quick fixes. The cup of coffee in the morning, the likes on a social media post, or even what some people call retail therapy. They all provide that momentary sense of joy. Let's shine a spotlight on the instant gratification of nicotine, the driving force behind this addictive habit. Vaping delivers a quick and powerful hit of nicotine, providing users with an immediate sense of satisfaction. The allure doesn't stop there, though. Vape products come in several appealing flavors, creating a sensory experience that goes beyond just nicotine. This combination of instant nicotine satisfaction and an assortment of flavors can easily draw people in, creating a habit that satisfies not only the physical craving, but also a sensory one. The act of vaping becomes tangled with moments of pleasure, making it a go-to for those looking for a quick escape. Now, let's uncover why nicotine, the addictive component in vaping, holds such power. Picture your brain as a happiness machine. It releases feel-good signals when something nice happens. Introducing nicotine tricks this system, causing a rush of dopamine, the happiness signal. Vaping becomes a quick route to that burst of joy. But there's a catch. Nicotine doesn't stop there. It works on other parts of your brain, heightening addiction. Over time, your brain adjusts, needing more nicotine for the same amount of pleasure. It's like your brain gets rewired. Think of it like your first cup of coffee. The initial energy burst fades over time, leading to a need for an extra shot of espresso. Similarly, our bodies adjust to nicotine, and dependence sets in. Understanding this brain science is crucial for making informed, smart choices about vaping. The rise of e-cigarettes among teen populations is one that should be reconsidered. Between 2014 to 2016, the advertisement for e-cigarettes was heavily aimed towards the focus of adolescents. A study discovered that 78% of middle school and high school students were exposed to at least one advertisement of vapes. The marketing creativity is seen in the various designs, packaging, and flavors of the pods. Having desirable flavors such as gummy bear or mint make the product more attractive to the young population and cause them to engage in the activity more due to its addictive flavor. A study shows a 10% increase in e-cigarette users among high schoolers in a year. This goes to show how much the marketing of vaping is exposing and influencing young adults and teens. So what exactly are the long-term effects of vaping? Vaping is often presumed to be a less harmful alternative to a traditional cigarette. Unfortunately, many adolescents and teens are not given the right information and are not educated enough to understand the negative impact it can cause on their life. Though vaping is harmful to all those that choose to use the e-cigarette, it is especially harmful to adolescents due to their brains still developing. Nicotine from the vape negatively impacts the brain on the synapses, which are the points of contact between brain cells where information is passed from one brain cell to the next. This can harm the specific parts of the brain that control attention and learning and create mood disorders. The nicotine exposure affects the brain's cognitive function and could cause hyperactivity and impulse behavior changes. The use of e-cigarettes among the teen population has shown to increase physical fighting, attempted suicide, and other drug abuse such as alcohol or marijuana. These are only some of the external issues that arise from vaping. An internal issue due to this problem is lung disease. Vaping can decrease lung function by causing inflammation in the airways, which can weaken their immune system, which is the system that defends the body against infection. This could potentially lead to popcorn lung, aka bronchiolitis obliterans. Popcorn lung affects the smallest airways due to the inflammation, which can scar the tissue and cause blockages. E-cigarette users also tend to have impaired blood vessels that increase their chances of heart disease. It is also increasing one's chance of heart attack by 42%. These long-term effects due to vaping are not spoken about enough, and it is greatly advertised for everyone to know the harmful effects prior to taking part in such activity. Due to the imminent risks of vaping, not everyone is aware of how severely it can affect one's health. It is helpful when physicians can educate and spread awareness of vaping. However, if parents can talk to their child about the risk as well, it will help reinforce the negative stigma on e-cigarettes. By partaking in advocacy organizations or by addressing the issues by presenting the facts at school will help educate children on the dangers of vaping. Through spreading awareness may not always be the most effective method, at least it will allow e-cigarette users to become aware of the dangers and get accurate facts to make their decision. Dangers of vaping are being masked by the mix of social pressure and its marketing tactics just so users can get a quick fix. However, understanding the impact of nicotine on a developing brain is crucial due to the various physical and behavioral issues it can lead to. Though it is often said that it is a safer alternative to smoking cigarettes, its long-term consequences are detrimental to one's health nonetheless. In a world where vaping is becoming more prevalent in teen populations, it is important for accurate information to be spread so that e-cigarette users understand what they're getting themselves into. We hope that you learned more about how vaping can affect one's health and why it is strongly advertised against using it. If you have any questions or would like to learn more, please feel free to reach out to your healthcare provider, and for more information, see the links in the description, or check out more videos on vaping on the Demystifying Medicine channel.